I am first draft of Go Go Gone.
And I am the first draft of Dil Chahta Hai.
And we are going to talk about Madgaon Express. So first of all, on top of it, the movie I want to call it is Madgaon Express. It's a mid. They can easily rename it to Madgaon Express because it's a mid movie, bro. And the way people are raving, like raging about it, like it's the comedy era is back in Bollywood and all. I think they have so low expectation that they're okay with mid. I'm saying like the way people are reacting to it. It's a good movie. I'm not saying it's a bad, like it's not a well-made movie. It's a really good movie. But then it's not that crazy that good people that are people are about. Talking that but comedy
before,
is back.
Before that, we need to set what the film is about and how the film starts and everything. So, Madgaon Express is basically a buddy comedy and crime as well in that. So, it's a buddy crime comedy.
So, it's basically
Hangover.
Dil Chahta Hai and Hangover, but Indianized.
Yeah.
More Indianized and 2024ized.
I would say that. Also, movie mein, there's not a very complex plot. Little bit of Nora here and there, but then other than that, the film is what he told. Exactly that.
So, the plot is, the plot concerns about three friends, right? Who grew up with each other till college. And then the three of them part their ways and...
No, before that, since childhood, they have been planning to go to Goa once in their life.
Yeah, I was going to come...
Are they part after that?
Okay. So their main goal of their life is to go to Goa once at least, with all the hard comings and all the obstacles
hurdles. What do you want, sir?
So everything, all of that, and they their journey, like their journey or their escapade to Goa, and how it ensues is what the story is about.
First Tag isn't about that. It's about Divyendu Sharma trying to. Live his childhood. It has more of a vibe of end of the world.
World's end.
Yeah, sorry, my bad. The world's end starts off as that only. He's trying to get his friends back and fulfill the dream that he had been having since childhood.
The three of them have parted their ways. Two of them are abroad, settled, and this Divyendu character lives vicariously.
But then tries to
emulate their life. Like he tries to show off.
Lives a fake persona.
Fake persona, like on social media, and how he makes them like convinces them to come back to India and like complete their dream of going to Goa. So that's the whole plot, and what ensues is the story. Like,
is the rest of the story, yeah.
When they get into different things,
and story starts.
So
like
first
that.
And foremost, I'll talk about the tone of the movie. It starts off very wacky and over dramatic, like OTT, very OTT, like over the top, right? But then after the credits roll, like the start credits roll, we're back to the normal realm, like normal. Then why did you set up the story like that?
For me, the movie goes in that zone in between. Like there's this song in the second half wherein Nora imagines. So at that time, the film goes wacky again. And then in between there are scenes that wherein they take drugs, the film goes wacky again at that point. In the start wherein they hit the water hydrant.
Yeah,
the film goes wacky at that time.
That's what I'm talking about, right? Like the setup for the story to begin and the way the story begins, both are tonally very different. And I think Kunal Kemu will like learn with each movie. He might get his groove while making new stuff. Yeah, that's a very nitpicky thing.
Gripe with not Kunal Kemu, but then new age directors that have been coming in the recent 10 to 5 years, wherein they have been picking up styles from Guy Ritchie and Edgar Wright. They're putting that in their film, but then that's not cohesive. Like they are not following it through. Like Tarun Bhaskar did that well in Kirakola.
I knew it. You were going to say Tarun Bhaskar.
I'm not bashing you. I'm appreciating him for saying ki usne bahut acche se kiya hai, cohesive rakha hai throughout the movie the style in that. And coming to Tarun Bhaskar, I'm talking about the opening credits of Madgaon, wherein they hit the water hydrant and they are in slow motion, the drink spilling and everything. that reminded me of E. Nagaran Came in the, yeah, the that's Tarun Bhaskar's second film. So in that the credits roll in a very similar way as it did in this film.
Yeah, the slow motion car.
So there were
the vomit thing also.
Ha, exactly. Wohi. So there were a lot of inspirations drawn from different movies. That's why thoda sa mixture ho gaya. And the tone wasn't very, what you say, uniform throughout the film.
Yeah,
I believe
yeah,
that.
Yeah, yeah. Tonally inconsistent, I'll say.
A lot of cool things were put, but then
yeah,
that's
a
why
lot
it
of.
Makes
sense. I mean, technically it was brilliant actually. When you look at the cinematography.
Brilliant, nahi bolunga, but then sound.
It does what it's supposed to do. That's what I'll say. Yeah, brilliant cause the way, see, I'll stick with my point. It's brilliant cause the way even big budgeted movies are coming right now, right? They feel quite artificial. Like, we know that they are shooting this in a studio, in a closed environment. But this doesn't feel, though it's a mid-budget movie, it doesn't feel quite artificial. Everything's quite natural. Like, yeah, I've seen that part. Like, I've been to Goa and I've seen those roads.
Those streets
I've
and everything.
Seen those streets, yeah.
मैं बताता हूँ मेरे को
felt quite real.
मेरे को कहाँ लगा लो बजट है. The entire film was good, मतलब कहाँ भी लगा नहीं. There is this chase sequence, रात के time पे they're running in the streets of Goa, where you can see कि they have done good. I'm not complaining, I'm just saying कि हाँ एक part था जहाँ मेरे को लगा.
That's a good
which
thing.
Which I'm not complaining. हाँ good, मतलब बराबर है. गुरिला करना पड़ता है उस जगह पे.
It felt quite fresh. हाँ. And music was not that memorable, bro. I mean, come on. They could have done a better.
It is supposed to be wacky, मतलब पूरा film wacky रखो. But then ऐसा moment. And there are a lot of music जो ऐसे ही आया अचानक से songs की अचानक से फटता है screen के बीच में.
Yeah, and the editing is well done, well crisp है. I mean, not that inconsistent. हाँ, but the thing is, why is Kunal Kembu there? Why does he pop up every
Hitchcockian appearance?
I mean, yeah, I know it's your movie, but you don't have to come onto the screen and tell people that.
Also,
yeah, this
also
is my movie.
Kind of he plays a very pivotal character, like in Khushi.
Like, is that a, I mean, Easter egg kind of a thing? Like,
for next one?
No, I mean,
Goa Gone. Achha, haan,
even
in that,
Goa Gone, he's a drug, like, he's
drug.
Into drugs and all, right? And here also, he's like the drug addict.
Narc,
who doesn't know where he is, right? So, yeah. अच्छी बात है भाई, अच्छा एक्ट करता है.
I thought तू मलंग का रेफरेंस देगा, where he is the narc officer, but that ठीक है. Let's go.
Haven't watched Malang, no. Won't watch. So we'll talk about the characterization. So Pratik Gandhi's character, you liked it, right?
हाँ, we have very opposing views on that.
So I'll go first, okay? So the thing is, I felt quite iffy because he's shown as a timid character.
बराबर
right? हाँ. Timid, shy, and everything.
Germophobic as well.
But then, when he comes to meet Divyandu, like he lands and meets Divyandu, there are certain like scenes where he feels quite elitist. And that like bothered me. Like, is he trying to be an elitist or is he trying to be a germophobe or the weak ass?
देख germo
Delhi Delhi guy.
Germophobe तो था पहले से.
हाँ, that he was, yes.
Elitist, I guess, because he has been.
Yeah, he is wearing all Gucci.
हाँ, और था.
Though he's dripped in Gucci.
हाँ, वो controlled environment में था, तो I guess वहाँ से आता है elitism.
But even like throughout, Avinash Tiwari's character is quite polished, right? Like he's from well, so that character.
It is polished, but then the problem was I didn't find the need for that. मतलब character.
Yeah, we'll come to that. I'm talking about characterizations for. Right.
For Pratik Gandhi,
So Pratik Gandhi felt quite iffy, but then later on he does really well with what he has. The facial expressions when he is on the drug trip, when he does coke.
मैं डरने का क्या है? मैं उन्हें सब संभाल लूँगा. I love Goa.
Bro killed it. I mean, we need more of comic roles for Pratik Gandhi. No, I'm saying I didn't like the characterization.
Achha.
Like the way they set up the character first, and then the way he evolves into. That's quite good. Like the way he portrays it is really well done, man. He aces every expression.
मेरे को तो लगा कि he was the best character in the film.
Yeah, he
बिचार सबसे ज़्यादा suffer करता है, उसका सूज जाता है पैर.
And he has a character arc.
हाँ, he has a character arc, and then सब उसके साथ ही सबसे ज़्यादा होता है.
I feel he's the main character.
सबसे ज़्यादा movement उसमें होता है. He's a vegetarian, and then he's put in a मच्छी mark and everything. उसका उंगली कट जाता है. A lot of things happens around him. मतलब he is always the victim of a lot of
the
things.
The most
so
safe guy, like who felt like safety is his first thing, right? And that guy loses his.
हाँ, this person who must be हाँ वो ही किया, वो अच्छे से किया.
Spoiler alert.
That's why मतलब वो सबसे अच्छा लगा मेरे को. दिव्येंदु का स्टार्ट अच्छा किया कि he is मतलब living a life of show, fake persona है online.
I think they made दिव्येंदु's nose quite big.
हाँ गया.
हाँ, I think they put a prosthetic nose for him.
ऐसा गया?
That felt quite odd, like काफी oddly बड़ा लग रहा था.
हाँ, but then हाँ दिव्येंदु का ऐसा डालते अच्छा है कीड़ा कि हाँ इसका ये problem है and then he's trying to not trying to fight that conflict, मतलब he's trying to live that on ऐसा and then he comes to terms with it. उसका भी ठीक है.
Yeah, it's good. He has a good character. Coming to Avinash Tiwari's character, I mean, even if we removed him, I mean, we would have lacked that eye candy for female gaze.
He is that arm candy. लड़कों में कोई तो अच्छा दिखना चाहिए.
Yeah, so we'd lack that.
I'm not saying कि प्रतीक गांधी और दिव्येंदु अच्छा नहीं दिखता. ऐसा नहीं
है. I'm saying he was solely.
हाँ, rip person एक चाहिए था group में.
We need that. Nora Fateh का dream sequence भी तो चलाना है.
हाँ.
So I mean, yeah, that character has no arc or like nothing to strive for.
Kind of thaus mein arc wherein online persona. Did that remind me of Mad by any chance? Telugu film.
I have very strong opinions. Like Avinash's character felt quite, I mean, meh.
End acha hua tha character ka, if you see. Ending I liked.
Parivartan.
Parivartan nahi tha, wo weird ending tha. कुछ तो इम्पोर्टेंट रहेगा पार्ट बिकॉज मतलब ऐसा नाम वाला बंदा है तो इट मस्ट हैव सम इंपॉर्टेंस.
द प्रॉब्लम विद दैट कैरेक्टर इज वो रेड हेरिंग जैसा एक्ट करता है. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल एक्सप्लेन रेड हेरिंग.
शार्क्स लेसन ऑफ द डे.
सो रेड हेरिंग इज बेसिकली गिविंग अ व्हाट यू से फॉल्स कल्प्रिट. यू आर डाइवर्टिंग द ऑडियंस अटेंशन सेइंग दैट दिस पर्सन इज द किलर वेयर इन द मेन किलर हैज बीन हाइडिंग. सो द राइटर हाइड्स द किलर बाय making you divert to a different person.
I mean, there's no such need of a red herring here, to be honest.
Unnecessarily confusing.
I mean, there are already many characters to play with.
You don't want to matlab, go that into like whodunit. So it was like more like I want to have fun in the film, comedy scenes and everything.
Yeah.
So here you're putting suspense, detective kind of thing. So
I mean, there are already 7 characters. You can play with those that Gonzalo. What was his name, bro?
उसका तो नाम बहुत ही मिसप्रोनाउंस करते खतरनाक. एक मैंडोलिन भाई.
मेंडोजा
गेम बजा लेगा क्या समझा.
या दैट गाय एक्टर रियली वेल. ही इज इन रियली गुड
मराठी एक्टर ना उपेंद्र लिमा है.
जोगवा इज इन जोगवा. सो या दैट्स अ ही इज अ गुड कैरेक्टर. एंड दैट काकू.
हां हां कोमड़ी.
कोमड़ी काका क्या गुस्सा.
थोड़ा कुणाल गेम एक पॉइंट पे अनअपोलोजेटिक हो
जाता
है.
I mean, equal weightage, like, right? Like, every character has equal weightage there. And every character is important to the story.
Nora ko mat gin, but theek hai, haan.
I mean, somewhere she is, because that through her we meet Remo, right?
Matlab, if you remove Nora and Remo ka arc and then you put them meeting a police officer in the start only, so there is other police officer also, right? इनके बारे में बात करते हैं जो जहाँ मतलब ही क्रॉस ड्रेसेस दिव्येंदु एंड प्रतीक.
ओह यार दैट्स अ
दैट सीक्वेंस.
ग्रेट एपिसोड.
क्रेजी है.
ग्रेट एपिसोड मैन.
अच्छा था. फनी था.
आई मीन दैट्स वेयर आई लाफ्ड माय हार्ट एक्चुअली.
देयर इज दिस सीन ही
संतरे संभाल.
हां और देयर इज दिस सीन क्या होता है कि ही किक्स द वुमन एंड देन इज लाइक आपको भी लगता है ना कि अच्छा अलाउड है ये सब बॉलीवुड में.
या दैट वाज अ clever actually. वो एक छोटा सा गैग है देख. The way that old woman comes and says let me handle that and she also flies away.
अरे भाई ओ.
That was clever man. That I mean there are some parts where Kunal Kemu shines man. He blows it out of the park. And for those moments I'll say yeah that's a good comment. That's a good.
ये comedy scenes में कोई ऐसा लगा कोई South Indian film का है. इधर इतना extreme जाते हैं.
You won't expect these kind of comedic tracks or comedic episodes from Bollywood movie, right? Like काफी वैकी मूवी
था वो वाला जो एपिसोड था ना दैट स्टूड आउट मतलब जब भी आया बाहर तो आई वाज लाइक कि हां बे ये खतरनाक था मतलब इफ डोंट लाइक द मूवी फॉर अदर थिंग बट देन दिस थिंग इज मतलब व्हाट आई लाइक्ड द मोस्ट इन द फिल्म लाइक दिस इज नया
आर वी गोइंग टू लाइक आर वी गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द एंडिंग
एंडिंग वी कैन मतलब
कर दे देगा सो सो द थिंग इज फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट द एंडिंग वाज सो प्रेडिक्टेबल लाइक सो सो प्रेडिक्टेबल ही कुड हैव डन a lot more like he played it very safe I felt I mean yeah we know like they are going to live a happy life that they are going to get caught come on man like if you did the wacky stuff for 1 hour 40 minutes why can't you like go on for more 20 minutes
true
do something wacky na I mean it was something new like the train like they meeting them meeting in the train that shoes wala thing
ha wo smart tha actually wo funny tha ha wo divendu ke comedy
self aware
ha comedic timing ke upar tha wo pura scenes jo bhi tha
there's a lot of commentary on like bollywood as well
ha ha
yeah you all should watch it I mean it's a good movie but yeah the coming to the ending underwhelming ending coffee
underwhelming but then there was a new fresh end to matlab kind of a fresh tweak wherein he क्या बोलते हैं forgives him but then also मतलब kind
yeah.
of
oh, in yeah. between there's no happy ending to be honest yeah
वो bitter sweet होता but then क्या मालूम फिर post credit करते तो भी understand कि नहीं था उसका इतना मतलब
see हाँ वही before the credits roll it feels quite refreshing like yeah that but then suddenly Divyendu's character goes back to his same life there's no like something else like यहाँ पे
मतलब अभी कुछ अलग नहीं होने वाला ठीक है यार अच्छा नहीं बनता वो भी होते वो type के भी character होते हैं ऐसा नहीं है
yeah that's quite real right felt quite real and then after the credits roll we see Divyendu has won a lottery and he goes to US I mean I know you are setting it up for the second part like I know the commercial aspect as well but then it beats the whole purpose of the ending before the credits right like you did the like it was very counterproductive like you did that and you fucked up by introducing him as the
barabar keh raha
right
wo matlab wo scene ho gaya ki the films have started teasing the sequels and then kind of started ruining it
yeah I mean the sequel wave should be stopped
but then you will have a memorable scene
yeah,
in that
yeah it's a good watch I mean, we are quite harsh on movies.
But then, if our episode releases and the film is still in theaters, you should give it a watch.
Yeah.
Because it deserves it.
Do try to watch it in theaters.